Oh, she broke up with me. Oh, I'm suffering.
Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, life is suffering, the Buddha said. Is that really so? Is life suffering? When do we suffer? Is it when we wake up in the morning? We are still grumpy, groggy? Is it when we have to go to work? Is it when we have to go to the toilet? Indigestion? Is that suffering? Is it when we are hungry? Is it when we are moody, sleepy? Is that suffering? Or is it later on when we have to see our parents die, our friends go, breakups, the drama of life? Is that suffering? The Bible says you should be in this world, but not of it. What does that mean? Essentially, you should witness life, but you shouldn't judge life. Only God can judge. You essentially can pretend to judge. That's basically what that really means. People say, only God can judge me, don't judge me, not realizing that people can't really judge. This is why I constantly tell you about the silent prayer. The silent prayer, called the Hesychast in Orthodoxy, is nothing but sitting in silence and observing what is. An ancient practice that you, yes, can find in other religions as well. For this, you don't have to be Orthodox. You don't have to be anything. You can simply sit in silence and observe what is. When you sit in silence and you observe what truly is, you will witness the absence of what is not. Essentially, you will realize, spoiler alert, that everything that you thought life is was happening in your mind. It was make-believe. So therefore, I'm not calling for wishful thinking, imaginary meditation practice. No, I simply call you to be still and to know God. The Bible says, be still and know that I am God. That's it. There is not much to it. People get trapped in theological debates, in who Jesus was, how is the shape, the form of God, is it a unity, is it a trinity, is it this, is it that? People are caught up in their intellect, constantly debating and talking, essentially not knowing God, being trapped in the delusion. Life is very, very simple. Understanding God is very, very simple as well. The intellectuals, the Pharisees, want to tell you that it's complicated, that you need them to understand God. You need to learn more. But this is not how life works. I'm a father now. Looking at my son, I know that he knows God without even talking. He knows God. He experiences God every single day. He experiences the isness of the moment without any interpretation, because he is still a baby. He's still a child. He's still pure. He is without sin, so to speak, because he isn't judging life. He doesn't pretend to know what life is. Life is very, very simple. If you make it complex, you will suffer.
Show me the studies.
This is suffering manifested. This is why vegans suffer. They suffer because they make life complex.
I'm using chronometer. I'm getting enough protein.
Don't you understand that the only reason that you are vegan is because you are trapped in your thoughts? You are thinking, you are emotional, you are rationalizing things. Why could plant protein be better? Why is it healthier? Why is it better for the environment? Or it is better for the animals? You're trapped in your thoughts. You know absolutely nothing. You are lost. You are misguided. Why? Because you create your suffering, and God will let you suffer. It is that simple.
Oh, if there is a God, why doesn't he help me?
It is up to you to return and reach out to God. God doesn't need you. God doesn't need to do anything for you. People say, oh, God is so evil. Why do I have to worship him? You don't have to worship him. It is quite obvious. If you don't want to worship God, you don't have to worship God. If you want to eat a vegan diet, you can eat a vegan diet. If you don't want to work out, you want to get fat, you can get fat. No worries. God will let you experience that suffering. Because apparently you haven't learned the lesson yet. This is why we have to let people go and make their own mistakes. Let them do it. Have fun with it. Guys, when I quit veganism, at first, I wanted to convert everybody to meat eating. Hey guys, don't you know the happy news, the holy gospel of the steak? Listen guys, it can save your life. Yes, it can. But now I realize that those people have to suffer. They have to suffer because they didn't get the memo. It is that simple. They didn't learn the lesson, and this is why they have to go through suffering. It is that simple. Life is simple. Life is beautiful. You have no idea how little thought goes into my life nowadays. You cannot plan what will happen in the future. As they say, life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans. But it is so true. You cannot determine what will happen in a couple of seconds. Hey, maybe I'm gonna do a car crash here. Maybe I'm gonna die. Who knows? Right now, I'm recording a video. And that's all I'm doing right now. Later on, when I'm in the gym, I'm gonna work out. And that's all I'm gonna do. Right then, right there. Later then, I'm gonna eat. And that's all I'm gonna do. And I'm gonna enjoy myself. And I don't experience any suffering doing it. Because suffering is only a construct of the mind. In the end, life is only experience. But you can experience all kinds of things if you're trapped in your imagination. Instead of experiencing pure God-given life, you will experience the constructs, the concepts of your mind.
Oh, she broke up with me. Oh, I'm suffering.
That's what you experience. Suffering is just an illusion. When you stop thinking, suffering ends. Alright guys, and this is it for today's video. Let me know in the comment section what you think. If you enjoyed it, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, guys, please do so. And as always, may God bless you all. Much love and peace.